Oh, Mexico.
Our gap behind is 1.5 seconds.
How's it feeling out there, Amy?
Yeah, good. I think we can start to push a little. Where's Casper?
Ahead of you. Don't worry about Casper, Amy. Let's just improve your current position.
Yeah, copy.
Oh. 1 second. Oh, there's a fucking fly that keeps flying by my face and it's annoying me and I can't... Why is Bottas in 10th?
Casper is 3 places ahead of you right now. Thank you.
this fucking fly, I swear to God. Got him.
It's clear from anyone watching, either in the stands or at home, the determination on show from Alfa Romeo and Aidan Jackson today.
No, you're not wrong there, Ant. His performance has improved race by race throughout the season, and his driving today, impeccable. Here's a test for him now, though, as they head down the main straight. There's a lot of friction between these two, and his teammates after him. Will he budge?
Hold position, Aidan.
Oh, I've never seen anything like this on a racetrack before. Two teammates wheel to wheel.
Oh, this is completely Casper's fault.
And they're both out of the race.
What a prick, like. Like, just blocking the fucking track. What can I do? Am I the only person that doesn't like any of the characters? I mean, I like Devin Butler.
Close the door. Sit down.
Completely Casper's fault.
What's going on out there? We've invested millions in you two. Millions. And look at you both. Acting like a couple of school kids.
Hi, Casper, you're like 40. Fucking wise up.
You've got a lot to prove this year, boy. And you're swanning around like butter wouldn't melt. And as for you, you should know better. I'm disgusted. Should both be ashamed.
Brian,
not a word. Not a single word. I should fire you both right here and now. You've screwed our chances this season.
Chances at what? I've gotten you the most points you've probably ever fucking seen in your life.
Your petty squabbles. Grow up! Any more, and you're both out. You hear me? I'll finish the season behind the wheel myself if I have to.
Do not feel fit, lad.
Both of you, get out.
Thank you.
say?
Threaten to fire both of us.
He won't.
That's not the point.
I'll just leave you be.
Is Lily okay? Does she know I'm safe?
Yeah. She saw you climb out. She's fine. I left her with your mother.
Okay, good.
You've survived worse, you know?
Doesn't make it any easier.
Maybe not, but you're not hurt. And you have a family who'll love you. The rest are just details. I'll see you later.
Right. So Lucas Weber, and this is a former F1 driver. Interesting. Next season already. Nice.
Here we are then, another season of Formula One racing is upon us. Some teams confident following pre-season, whilst others still looking for answers. Let's see what the future holds for them as qualifying gets underway here in Melbourne. So, Aidan Jackson in ninth. Still hopeful that the youngster can secure a decent position. Let's see how he gets on here. Teammate Casper Ackerman didn't make it through to Q3, narrowly missing out by just
13 milliseconds. You did all you could. If I went out second today, I would have those 13 milliseconds back, no problem. Why do they keep sending me out first?
11th isn't the end of the world, Casper. You'll make those places back.
Yeah, for sure. Shouldn't have to.
Zoe, hey.
Morning, Daddy.
Lily.
Wait, no, I'm Casper.
It's not morning where Daddy is, right?
Mummy says you're on the other side of the world.
And that's right. Daddy is in Australia. I'm upside down.
Then why don't the cars fall off?
Mummy can explain that. Can I speak to her?
Don't fall off, Daddy.
I won't, Lily. Promise.
Hey, qualifying not so good, huh?
They sent me out first.
Again?
Yeah.
Well, some of your best races were coming from midfield.
Yeah?
Yeah. Besides, I thought you loved a challenge. Lils, off the table. Now, it's breakfast time. I should go.
Sure.
You'll be great. You always are. Love ya.
Love you too.
That's Madras.
Something's not right. Where are we? It's the gearbox.
Push on, Casper. We're assessing. Just push on best you can.
That's right.
So he's went purple in the middle sector with a gearbox issue.
Okay, bad news on the gearbox. The team are trying everything they can think of, but they're not optimistic. Just keep at it, do your best. That's all we can ask for.
Okay. I came out of nowhere. So, of no seventh gear. Interesting.
There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Gap to teammate ahead is 2.8 seconds.
This corner again.
Laps of fuel remaining. the race. Over. Take care of the car on the way in.
A great race then, and a fantastic victory here at Albert Park. Well, what's happened there to Kasper Ackermann? Still managed to finish? That's got to be frustrating, Ant.
Yeah, looks like maybe it was a gearbox fault, which is always a blow for the driver. Ackermann won't be happy, but I'd say he's done very well in the circumstances.
Well, this isn't the start he would have wanted after last season. Let's hope things pick up for him. So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot. A well-earned victory for Mercedes.
Bad luck out there today. Let's talk about it. So, not a great race out there for you today, Kasper. Can you talk us through what happened?
Well, it was clearly an issue with the gearbox. Not a great place to be as a driver, but we'll work on it, I'm sure.
Well, despite obvious vehicle difficulty, you still managed to finish. How hard is it to bring it over the line when facing such issues?
Well, this is where experience comes in. You just have to switch off. Be mindful, but try and ignore what is going on around you. To concentrate only on the problem at hand, and hope for the best.
While it's an unfortunate start to this season, last season was muddied by a tense relationship with your teammate. How are things now with you and Aiden?
That was last season. It's no secret that Aiden and I had a few run-ins. But that's a risk when you put two drivers together for the first time. I don't like to look back, only forward. I'm sure he's learned a lot, and we'll see what happens this season.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you. attacks now.
No, it's a coming. Oh, it's quite bad.
We've got Aiden coming in now. Just hold out one more lap, please, Casper.
Is there that bell?
Yes, he's got a different strategy.
Haven't I got priority?
He's boxing now. Please hold off, Casper.
Fine.
Must have been pretty urgent for Casper, huh? Like,
okay, that wasn't ideal. Let's see if you can get a few places back, please, Casper.
Come on in.
Thank you.
seconds. Some breathing space between you and the car behind by a few seconds per lap. Laps of fuel remaining. Seconds.
What is this audio? Where Valtteri Bottas wins like every race.
Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
Interesting little encounter between Ackerman and Jackson in the pit lane, and might that cause more friction behind the scenes? After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it.
That was an exciting race from our perspective. Let's have yours.
Congratulations on a tough race today, Casper. To all of us watching, it seemed as if there was some sort of clash in pitting strategy. Can you talk us through it?
Well, it's unfortunate, but these things happen. I felt the tires begin to go off and realized I needed to come in. It was a calculated risk. There's not much else to say. I pulled it back and finished the race, so no harm done.
So the problem we all witnessed today was a team call, and not a sign of continuing tensions again this season between you and Aidan Jackson.
Well, I'm not going to lie, as I'm sure it's obvious to everyone here.
It's really stupid how they brought in the lap car first.
Which causes some tension. But we're also professionals. So it shouldn't get in the way of our performance. I'm sure we'll work through it. Why do you ask?
Well, you seemed angry on the radio with your team. People are asking if that's an indicator of a deeper issue behind the scenes. What would you say to that?
Well, of course I'm angry. I mean, irrespective of today's result, the team isn't working together at peak efficiency, in my opinion. It's frustrating. We'll see what the rest of the season brings, but I think we've all got work to do.
Appreciate your time.
I just don't get it, Zoe. He gets to pit ahead of me, and they give his car the only new power unit last season. And he gets to go out behind me in qualifying. This kid is a new number one driver.
I don't believe that to be true.
But then why does he get paid more?
You're still upset about that.
No. Well, I don't know, maybe. I just wish I never found out.
It's not the money, though, is it?
I'm old.
You're not old.
Like this again. I am old. For a driver, I'm old.
Come on, this is your last season. You said you'd make it count.
I still need to tell them.
Will you?
Soon.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, forget about Jackson.
Okay.
And stop playing the victim. It doesn't suit you.
All right, okay.
It's Zandvoort next, remember? Everyone's gonna be rooting for you. Be the guy they love. And hey.
What?
Be the guy I love.
That's cute. Did you come up with that yourself?
I'm a natural born charmer.
Yeah. Verstappen's got nothing on me.
You had to ruin it.
Hello and welcome to Zandvoort for another round of Formula One action. Zandvoort Circuit then. 14 corners, 10 to the right and 4 to the left, with plenty of steep camber and elevation changes to keep our drivers on their toes throughout the 2.6 mile lap. And watch out for cars making use of the DRS zone into turn 1 to try and overtake. And so here we are, Zandvoort. If there's one thing you can guarantee, it's the incredible atmosphere these Dutch fans provide. The sea of orange shirts as much a part of the Grand Prix as the track itself. Max Verstappen all with the race.
The crowd's all behind you today, Cass. Let's use that momentum and see what you can do out there.
He's still there. Oh wow. And again. Jesus Christ. Science is so slow off that corner, like.
Okay, good work. Great pass.
Nice. Nice. I broke in the wrong area.
6, you've moved up into P6.
They are so slow off that corner.
Okay, gap ahead is 4.2 seconds.
Alright. Thank you for that, Jeff. What happened there? That's great. It's also great. arse. The audio cues are really weird and don't make sense. There's no car even near me. It sounds like there's a car in a tunnel next to me. There's no car near me.
This lap, so push now.
Is 2.5 seconds.
Welcome
now.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
Wow. All of the downforce went then? I mean, if we watch this back,
okay, clear.
He didn't leave me any space when I clearly had the speed. Had the overspeed and he just didn't. Just turned in on it.
Teammate by 38.5 seconds.
Yeah. See, these audio cues make a bit more sense because there's cars on the other side of the track there. But then there's times the audio cues come in and there's no one near me at all. Oh my god, like... I'm more worried about the car in front, you know what I mean? Jeff, if I'm not mistakenly.
Brings you up the place.
Thank you.
Okay, so now the car sounds like a Formula E car. Because the rest of the engine sounds like it's died.
Final lap. Final lap of the race.
Well, that's hilarious. There's a lot of audio problems at the start of this game. Already. But other than that, everything's working pretty decently. That's just tough getting adapted to the less downforce.
To the podium now, and what a result this is!
Well, decent enough victory.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. A podium finish today, Casper, here in front of your home crowd. How does it feel?
Well, my family's here today, my wife and my daughter, so I'm delighted I was able to have a good race for them. It means the world to have them here. I think I would have been miserable tonight if I didn't have a good race, which wouldn't have been fun for anyone. So yeah, I'm really happy.
And the fastest lap too today. Is that something you expected?
It's realistically not something you think you're going to get too often, so no, I can't say we expected it. But it's certainly a welcome surprise. Every point counts, so come the end of the season, we might be more grateful for it than we realize.
How is everything at Alfa Romeo? Are spirits high? Is the team happy?
Yes, of course. We've had a bit of a bumpy start, but we're looking to rectify that, and thankfully we got a lot of races left, so we're looking forward to the season ahead. But the only thing you can ever really focus on is the next race. So that's what I'll be looking to do.
Great. Well, that's everything.
Hey, man. Great race today.
Thanks. Nice one, Casper. Can't argue with that performance. Shame your teammate couldn't bring himself to congratulate you.
Yeah, well, he's just a kid.
Well, kid is getting signed by Ferrari.
So they say.
Never gonna happen.
Oh?
You keep a secret?
Yeah, sure.
I've been approached.
Really? Well, congratulations.
Keep it under your hat, but talks are going well. So you're gonna have to get on with Jackson for a little while longer.
Yeah, well, we get on fine.
That's not what I heard.
Yeah?
I was chatting with one of your mechanics. He had some very interesting things to say about Jackson. You know what his problem is, don't you?
Go on.
Thinks you're getting too old. Says you're not fast enough anymore.
Too old?
Just won the race.
Mate, his words, not mine.
Fastest lap.
You want my advice? Prove him wrong. See, he should respect you like I do. great race out there today, buddy. Yeah? Ciao.
Dancing in the garage. It's hilarious. Can you come?
Just catching up on a few things.
Sure. Hey, I booked us a restaurant for tonight.
What about Lily?
Your mother's happy to take care of her.
Great. Then I can't wait.
Reason to celebrate, right?
Yeah. Thanks, Zoe. See you later.
Bye.
All right. I'll end the stream here. Thanks for watching.